Welcome back, guys. Today we're defeating the biggest beaver in all of North America, the Ender Dragon. You know me, Chris Columbus. I love beaver, so why not tackle the largest one? I'm just gonna quickly gather some materials to prepare for the fight, because I've only ever beat the Ender Dragon in survival, so let's go do that. I've already gotten some blaze rods and ender pearls, as you saw last time, so those are good to go. I just gotta get some blocks and food, and then I think I should be good. I also decided to gather some sugarcane for fireworks for when I become an A10 warthog. After that, I went ahead and crafted the ice vendor. I made 14 of them because I thought, meh, that's probably enough. I then started on my ridiculously easy journey, actually, to find the stronghold. It was so much fun. I had much fun. Minecraft is a fun game. So what was happening here was that I had been going back and forth over the same patch of ocean for about 5 minutes, having no idea where the stronghold was, because I kept going too far in one direction. Finally though, I did end up finding it. It shouldn't come as a surprise that my stronghold was underwater, considering my upcoming luck. It's not all bad though, because I mean, the stronghold is actually fairly close to the village. So, once I finally dug down far enough and got the I Spy achievement, it was time to do perhaps the most annoying part of Minecraft, at least most annoying for me. Find the portal room. So, I mean, I was already off to a great start. Two creepers just combusted in my face, and I got chased by a swarm of silverfish. It's already going great. How can it get any better? Don't worry, my friends. It gets a lot better. Like much better. I ran around for literally 15 minutes, and I found nothing. Absolutely nothing. I'm actually about to cry, dude. It was so bad. The only source of entertainment was killing mobs. And you know it's bad when killing mobs isn't mildly annoying. It's mildly entertaining. I literally had to go through walls. I had to dig through walls to find more part of the stronghold, dude. It was like a trail ruin. It was so bad. After about 25 minutes of running around, though, I finally found a new part of the stronghold. A library. So this was good. This was good. We were getting some luck. And it wasn't a portal room, but it did have an armor trim, so that was great. That was great. But please, just the portal room. I then killed some more mobs, and guess what I found right after? Another library! Dude, please! Please! Just give me the portal room! I mean, you know what? It had decent loot, so I'm not complaining. I mean, listen, I got breach too from a stronghold. That's actually great, so I mean, you know what? Don't mind if I do. I then ran around some more, and then... we did it! We did it! Finally! After 40 literal minutes, dude, why? It's not that deep. Well, I mean, it's underwater, but still, it's not that deep! Please! It doesn't have to be this complicated, man! And then I started recording again the next day, because my sister wanted to put the eyes in when she was asleep. So, let's kill this bit. Beaver. Beaver. And no other bad word whatsoever. I mean, you all know how this fight goes. It's pretty basic. I shot down all the crystals. And then I also landed some incredible clutches. Can we get a clutch counter? There we go. Thank you. Ready? Watch this. It was crazy. It was insane. I'll just let my voice fade out and do the montage. That was perhaps the best pearl I've ever thrown ever. I interrupted the montage for that. So I have no idea where the footage for the 10th crystal went, but don't worry, I did break that for sure. And then this happened. Dude, I was in the void. I was in the void. Look at, dude, oh my goodness. That's, you won't see that in Dream Manhunt. Never. You never see that. I'm better. I'm just better. I'm just better. I then landed even more clutches because I'm better than Dream. I don't know what to tell you. We'll be right back. I then pulled a Princess Merida. Here's a bow montage. And then I went back in for the axe. And also missed 9 shots. He was on. He 2 more arrows would have done the job. But no, I had to miss 9 shots. But you know what? Here it is. Here it is. I hope you liked it. I hope you liked it, you sadists. You actual. I hope you liked seeing me suffer. Alright? There you go. Have fun. That was my first time defeating the Ender Dragon in hardcore, so I got the Dragon Egg using rocket science. And bam, the next generation. Yeah, I'm gonna make an omelet with the next generation of the Ender Dragon, dude. I then entered the End Gateway and just ran in a straight line until I came across an End City. It honestly, surprisingly, didn't take that long. It was like, I actually found one really quickly. And it had a ship too, so you know what? There's my reward for bearing through that terrible, terribly annoying 40 minutes of running around the stronghold. I was too chicken to actually fight my way up the End City, so I did something riskier and just towered up to the End Ship. Then I killed the shulkers there. Got the elytra and the dragon head. And I flew back home. Like I said, I had fireworks already because I always plan ahead. Honestly, very uneventful overall, except for the 5 times it almost died. But yeah, you know how it goes. I entered my gateway and jumped into the portal, beating the game. But this is just the beginning. I can literally be an A10 warthog now, dude. That creeper, he's got cooked. I can finally go and break that torch up there that's been nagging me for so long. Perfect landing. Totally not my 5th try at it. Holy moly, we did it, guys. Next episode, we're about to become immortal with a fun, silly raid farm. I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. I know the footage was really choppy. I tried my best with it. The next episode won't be this heinous. I fixed the problem. It's all good. Don't worry. Thank you all for watching.